An unprecedented partnership has prevented the extinction of the only rabbit native to greater New England, the New England cottontail. Extinction threatened this once common cottontail as its young forest habitat disappeared from the landscape, shrinking the species' range to 5 isolated populations across 6 states.
The New England cottontail has declined by over 80% over the last 50 to 60 years. We've lost a lot of this habitat to succession, which is growth into mature forest. Of course that's going to happen, but we also don't have natural disturbances like were here prior to European settlement that used to create this habitat naturally.
These trees will be cut and removed to create openings in the forest canopy to encourage young sapling growth to create a thicket of vegetation that is not only excellent for New England cottontail, but other early successional species.
Habitat projects are showing increased number of cottontails, and the effort is closing in on the 2030 population goal. For the first time in history, New England cottontails were successfully bred and raised in captivity in several locations.
We're here on Patience Island today to complete the third leg of a journey which began at Roger Williams Park Zoo. These rabbits were born 8 to 12 weeks ago and now have been relocated to Patience Island and released into the wild environment so that they can begin to reestablish an on-site population, a self-sustaining population that can later be used to restock into areas of the mainland where habitat has been created.
The Partnership to Save New England Cottontail has united foresters, farmers, landowners, hunters, and other conservationists.
My goal is to leave this property in a manner that provides for wildlife. Fortunately, I've worked with representatives from a variety of agencies that are willing to help me to keep the farm as open space and farm some of the areas, but improve the habitat for a species that I now have become more aware of and realize the importance not just for the rabbits, but other species of animals and birds.
Well, when you look at what young forests provide, they're crucial for the New England cottontail, but they're also crucial for 69 other species, reptiles, small mammals, insects, birds, and other species that have been on the decline since the early 1900s.
The only indigenous species of rabbit is the New England cottontail. So we also relate to them as we are indigenous. We are the indigenous people of this property. Those are our indigenous brothers.
This is a species that is becoming less and less common, that has the potential to face extinction, but we have the opportunity to reset the clock.
8 years of fruitful efforts to restore young forest and return this native species to our region have led us to the decision that the New England cottontail does not require Endangered Species Act protection. But this good news does not mean our work is done. Plans are in place to continue the conservation effort, and more success is on the horizon, ensuring New England cottontails and young forest remain part of our landscape for generations to come.